Good afternoon. As a lot of you may know, I've been having a rodent problem. And a couple years ago when I had a rodent problem and they were getting into my cage that Sweepy was in, I made baffles to go around the legs. And I'm going to have to do it again. So these are the things that you're going to need. A ruler or a tape measure, a pen, white glue, something to spread the white glue, a dinner plate, scissors, zip ties or nylon cable ties, aluminum foil, and poster board. Now this is going to be several parts because I can't film this all in one shot because the aluminum foil is going to be glued onto the poster board. And I'm not using yellow. I'm going to use white, and I'll show you the difference here in a second. Be right back. Okay. The color paper has two matte sides. And you're going to want one side that is not matted. So this is a matte side. But if you look at the white, it has a sheen to it and a matte side. The matte side is where you're going to draw your plates in. And you're going to draw one for each leg. Now this is an 11 inch dinner plate. The bigger the plate, the more surface you have to curl around. And I'll show you in a minute what I'm talking about. But I'm going to go draw 11 plates on. And also, if you can find them with the sticker, without stickers like this, get them. The stickers are a pain in the butt, in my opinion. But they have to have a way to, you know, mark them, sell them. Now, the poster board I bought was at Dollar Tree, and the white is thicker than the yellow is. So I'm going to go draw dinner plates up, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Okay, I have four legs. This is going to be one, two, three, four. And like I said, I don't like the sticker being in it, but it is what it is. Now, each of these, you're going to divide in half this way and this way, so you have a center point. 11 inch dinner plate, the center point will be 5.5 inches, but you want to have a dead center in the middle. So I'm gonna go do that. Be right back. Okay, this is approximate, it's not exact, because I'm not good with rulers, but you get the main idea. You want to divide it into quarters. So what you're going to do next is you're going to cut out each circle all the way around and stay as close to the line as possible. Each circle is going to represent one cone to go on a leg. Okay, I've got one complete circle cut out. Now what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to cut up one of these lines so that you have an open section. Be right back. Okay, the line is cut right here. I'm going to pick this up so you can see it. The center, you're going to want to cut out a tinier circle. So you may want to go around the leg of your cage and figure out how big that circle needs to be. Mine are fairly tiny, so I know to cut it fairly small. But I would say don't cut it any bigger than what the four sides of each leg contain or are. Okay, that's the hole in the center. Now I'm going to go wrap it around the leg, one of the legs, and see how well it fits. Be right back. Okay, it had to be a little bit bigger, but you get the general idea. Now, what you're going to do on this side of it is you're going to take aluminum foil in a single swap and glue it down. And I'll show you how to do that in a minute. Be right back. Okay. Took me a few seconds to get foil out of the box. Anyway, this is a sheet of foil. This is the size. You want the foil on the flat or matte side, and you're going to white glue it down so that it stays in place. And I'll show you how to do that in a minute. Be right back. Okay, the glue's on. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to slide this off the aluminum foil for a second. I'm trying not to make a mess. And lay the aluminum foil on the round. I'll kind of pat it into place. And just a heads up, this takes time to dry, so be prepared to wait until it's dry. Kind of pat it into place. And what I do is I'll do up all of these at one time, and then I'll let them sit and dry. Now you're going to repeat this until you have the same amount as the number of legs. So on a four-legged cage, you've got four rounds. Once it's dry, then I'm going to do a second video to show you the final steps. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask them in the comment section. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.